We can't go back. They won't leave us alone. And there's no way, no way we can survive.
As being our best qualities. Thank you.
Do not swat a fly on a friend's head with a hatchet. And thus, when the law is laid down too firmly, and all religions have the temptation to do this, it puts the observance of the law in danger, just as swatting the fly on a friend's head with a hatchet puts his head in danger. Now you see, a religion, then, as I've defined it, comes into being because of the necessity for someone to lay down the law in order that there shall be a human community. And so if we go back to the social origins of religion, I can think we can understand how this purpose works. And so let's go and look at the board, and I want to try and put this in a diagrammatic form. Religions as a phenomenon seem to have arisen historically with the transition from what we might call hunting cultures to agrarian cultures. In the type of life which we'd call the hunting or nomadic culture, we don't really have religion in any institutional sense. Instead of the priest, there is the shaman. And a shaman is a man who has a religious experience of his own. He goes out into the forest and he meditates, he encounters the forces of the unknown, the spirits or whatever it may be. And from his own experience, he acquires his magical powers, which give him a certain respect in the community. Also, in the hunting culture, every male member of the culture knows all the culture. In other words, he knows all the arts and skills necessary for survival. And a very different situation arises, where a settled agrarian culture comes to birth. And rather naturally, such a culture comes to birth at a place where people meet. You might say, at crossroads. Thank you.